Our top story now, a changing of the guard at Shelby County's top prosecutor. Democrat Steve Mulroy is taking over as Shelby County D.A. when he's sworn in next month. Now, this comes after a resounding double-digit election night victory over Republican incumbent Amy Weirich. His win means a different management and philosophy of how to address public safety as well as punishment. Brad Broders is here in the studio now. Brad, the election is over, so now what?
Well, Richard, a criminal justice reform advocate, Mulroy's win gives new hope to new ideas and a different vision of how cases are tried and defendants are held. For years, criminal justice reforms were a main focus for those with the Memphis Interfaith Coalition for Action and Hope, or MICA. Among their goals, creating a conviction review unit, cutting down on juvenile transfers to adult system, and lowering bonds for some nonviolent offenses. MICA leaders admit while those proposals are a lot to tackle, if Mulroy can at least implement some of them, they believe it will go a long way in making the justice system more just.
With us having a new DA, it gives us the opportunity to have somebody, obviously, with new ideas, somebody who's going to come in with fresh eyes into the position. And so that's always a good working point for us.
Local political analysts believe Mulroy's honeymoon won't last long, especially with recent high-profile cases. Next month, Mulroy will decide on whether to rescind Amy Weirich's recommendation to try the accused 15-year-old killers of Reverend Atora Eason Williams as adults.
We really don't know yet what will happen with Mr. Mulroy, who is a law professor and never managed an office like the DA's office. How will that happen? What will happen there?
Now, Mulroy takes over as Shelby County District Attorney September 1st. Richard?
What did Mulroy tell supporters last night as far as what they can expect with him as the new top prosecutor?
Well, Steve Mulroy promised that the Shelby County DA's office would be a model for reform. And though he conceded reducing violent crime won't happen overnight, he promised to make local streets safer through his leadership. In the studio, I'm Brad Broders.